YouTubers. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me today. I want to talk about this earthquake that USGS reported near St. Louis along the New Madrid fault zone. 278 people sent in reports to USGS. They gave it an intensity level of 4, which means it was felt indoors by many people, outdoors by a few. At night, some may have been woken up. Dishes, windows, doors were rattling. Automobiles rocked noticeably. I got one station to download the data, and it is 55 miles, a little more than 55 miles, or it was 88.81 kilometers from where this earthquake occurred. And here you can see, yeah, the Mississippi River. A lot of farming. Yeah, all the homes. We have St. Louis. This is about the largest earthquake that's been there in a while. Yeah, up over here is St. Louis. Recently, there was a magnitude 2.8. That was on April of this year. And a 2.4 also. Well, that was actually last year. They probably don't want to create a panic, but this was much larger. It was actually a magnitude 3.10. And I'll show you the spectrogram or the seismic signature. And this was all tectonic in movement. Yeah, all sharpened points. As you know, we have a major problem with shipping of goods from the Mississippi because of drying up. If there was a large earthquake on top of that, yeah, blocking the route or delivery of the goods, all the grains and goods that, yeah, right now I guess they're only going in one direction. You might think about, because of this drought, planting a garden next year. Yeah, evidently there's going to be in fact there is already, a shortage of tomatoes, and you've seen the price of lettuce and eggs. Yeah, I would probably plan on planting a garden. All right, just along here, we got, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bridges going over the Mississippi River. Is that another one? 7. Yeah, not good if there's a large earthquake. When I went through there last year on my way to Florida, it was amazing how many buildings were brick and mortar. They would not hold up very well, if at all, in a large earthquake. And then you have liquefaction. Yeah, this whole area, the ground would turn to quicksand. And everything would just sink into the ground. Only one person sent in a report to EMSC, and all they stated was their zip code. This monitor is from Cathedral Cave, Missouri, so it's not going to pick up outside noise. And you can see here we got several other small earthquakes that have occurred lately. And we got some more, yeah, looks like tectonic movement currently going on as I'm making this video. These earthquakes are not being reported. Like I said, I don't think they want a panic. There's another one right there, and I'll go to its seismic signature. This one right here is probably a magnitude 1.94, close to a 2. So if you think you're feeling shaking going on, you probably are. Let's see what this other one is. We'll take it right there. And it comes in as a magnitude 2.25. They're not reporting them. Here's that earthquake that I just reported that was a 3.1. And there was others. Let's see, there was one actually marked in red. Let's see, right there. 6:27 Universal Time. Maybe about 12 a.m. That's deep. It could have been caused by an earthquake someplace else around the world. Let me go back up here. And the date would have been, yesterday it looks like. Yeah, yesterday morning. 12:06. But there's been other smaller ones here. We got one there. Let's go to the seismic signature. And I don't know. That very well could be there too. That one could have been something someplace else around the world. Now, experts, yeah, the so-called experts will tell you that there's a 7 in 10 chance of being a 7.0 earthquake. Can you imagine all the people that would die if there was that big of an earthquake there in St. Louis? They also have a hazard map for 1 second period time of shaking for that, 7.0. Most large earthquakes last for about a minute, and this is just 1 second of shaking. Here we have a scenario for a magnitude 5.8 beneath downtown St. Louis. Yeah, 5.8, and yeah, percentage of area expected to liquefy. Yeah, look at that. I wish I could make it clearer for you. I might try and make it bigger, but it's probably just going to get blurrier. Let me see. Yeah, that's the best I can do. For all of you that felt this earthquake, it should be a wake-up call to be prepared for a large earthquake. Have a plan in place where you're going to get under something very strong. When your building collapses. Don't get on the bed. Get beside the bed. The bed frame and the mattress might give you a pocket to hide in if the ceiling above you collapses. Have everything that you can that would hurt somebody bolted to the wall. So did you feel this earthquake? If so, please put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.